Hello friends, welcome back to our channel. So in the previous session we have seen the abstract methods and the interfaces, right? So interfaces are used to achieve the multiple inheritance. Now in this session we will see the exception handling. Right, so here the name itself indicates exception handling. So exception, that means the interruption for our flow of data, right? Whatever the code we are writing, so if there is any interruption or if there is any error, automatically we call it as an exception. So our main drawback is if there is any exception occurred in our program, automatically the rest of the code will not be get executed and the program will be terminated abruptly, right? So this is for avoiding abnormal termination of program. So whenever an exception is raised, the program will be terminated abnormally, right? So in order to avoid that abnormal termination, we will use this exception handling. So here we will use a more number of keywords. So actually 5 keywords we will use, that is try, catch, throws, finally. So all these will be used in exception handling. So first let us see these two in this session, try and catch. Try block, so it is a block of statements, so what are these block of statements? So in this we have to write the code in which we are expecting the exceptions. So we have to assume or we have to expect some exceptions to be raised in the code. Such type of code should be written in try block. So try block is a normal execution of the statements, right? And catch, it is also a block of statements, but the difference between this try and catch is whatever the exceptions raised in this try block, those exceptions will be handled in catch block. Handles exceptions raised in try block, right? So all the exceptions will be raised in try block and it will be handled in catch block. So without try block, we should not write the catch block, and without catch block, we should not write the try block. See, I will show you the syntax for these things, try and catch. So try some statements, catch, we have to pass the exception, some E or EX. So whatever the code we want to execute, right, after handling this exception.
See, this is a syntax for try and catch block. So without the catch block, we should not write the try block, and without the try block, we should not write the catch block. Both are the interrelated blocks. Both are interrelated blocks.
Right.
See, our exceptions are categorized into three types. One is checked exceptions. Unchecked exceptions errors, right? So here we know that errors, so all the logic errors and syntax errors and as well as some IO errors, everything comes under these errors. Now we have to know about this checked and unchecked exceptions. Checked exceptions are also called as compile time exceptions. That means they will be checked at the compile time itself. So compile time exceptions. So these are called runtime exceptions. So these are unchecked. That means these exceptions are not checked at the compile time. So these are called the runtime exceptions. So example for these runtime exceptions are arithmetic exception, number format exception, array index out of bounds exception, null pointer exception, etc. All these are the runtime exceptions, right? So everything is available in throwable class. So all these exceptions are available in throwable class, right? Which is available in some lang package, okay, java.lang, which is implicitly called by the Java compiler. So these are the classes available in this throwable class, right? These are the exceptions available in throwable class. So if you want to handle the exception, we have to write these exceptions as perfectly. That means every first letter of every word should be in a capital letter. See, in the arithmetic exception, A and E are the capitals, right? And in the number format exception, N, F, E are the capitals. Array index out of bound, A, I, O, O, B, E. All these are the capital letters. In the null pointer exception, N, P, E are the capital letters. Right? So these are the exceptions, so few exceptions comes under these runtime exceptions, right? So let us see what is about these arithmetic exception, null pointer exception, and everything. See here. Arithmetic exception. So arithmetic exception means the basic thing is divided by zero. So whenever we are performing any statement or computation which is having this divided by zero, so in some a is equal to some 8 divided by zero, so actually the output for this is nothing but infinity, right? So such type of exception we call it arithmetic exception. Next, null pointer exception. See, example, I will show you null pointer exception. Let us take one string str is equal to null. So I am assigning some null to this str and I am trying to print the length of the string. Actually, it is assigned to null,
and I am trying to print str.length. So in such case, it is called the null pointer exception, because str doesn't have any initialization, but we are accessing the length of the string, right? So this is called the null pointer exception. So everything I will show you on the system, right, so that your doubts will be clarified. Next, the number format exception. What is the number format exception? Number format exception means string str is equal to, let us take one string hello, right, and if the user is trying to typecast this one, right, that means converting this string to integer, so 5 is also a string, typecasting 5 to numeric, so str to int, this is possible. But hello is a string, if you try to typecast it to integer, automatically we will get this number format exception. See, so int number is equal to integer dot parseInt of str, automatically, so here we are converting the string to the number, right? So which is not possible. Hello is the string. If you want to convert this hello to the number, it is not possible. So in such case, we will get the number format exception. Next, array index out of bounds exception. Right? Array index out of bounds exception. The name itself indicates array index. So here, array means it consists of the elements, a number of elements, multiple elements, right? So in order to access those elements, that access can be done through index values, right? So if the index values are out of range, then this type of exception will be occurred. So during the initialization and declaration, we have to specify the size for the array, and the user is able to access the index of beyond the size, then automatically this index out of bound exception will be raised. See, for example, int some a is equal to new int some 5. So this is the just a declaration of an array, so which consists of a size 5. So here we are mentioning the size as 5. So here the index values are from 0 to 4. So next statement, if I am able to access, or if I am trying to initialize some 5 or 10 or 15 to the index which is out of range, that is here only the index is range from 0 to 4. Here I am assigning the value for a of 6, index 6, which is out of boundary. In such case, this exception will be raised. Array index out of bound exception will be raised. Okay, so these are the few exceptions comes under runtime exceptions. These are all the runtime exceptions. So in the try block, we have to write the code which we are expecting the exceptions, and in the catch block, we have to write the exceptions, all these exceptions we are trying to handle, right? So whatever the exceptions raised in the try block will be handled in the catch block. And once again, I'm repeating, this exception handling is mainly used to avoid the abnormal termination of a program. If any exception is raised, then automatically in the catch block, that particular exception will be handled, and immediately the rest of the code will be executed. So in the absence of exception handling, so if there is any exception raised in one statement, automatically the program execution will be terminated. So rest of the code will not be executed, right? So in order to avoid that thing, we will use this exception handling. So we will stop here, and let us see the implementation part of all these four exceptions in the system.
Hello friends. So just now we have seen about the exception handling in Java. So as we have said that exception handling is used to handle the exceptions, right? So if you are having any errors in our program, then automatically the code will be terminated. So in order to avoid that abnormal termination of the code, we will use this exception handling, right? So that whenever an error occurred in the program, automatically that exception will be raised and the rest of the code will be executed as usual, right? So for this, for handling the exceptions, we will use the two blocks, that is try block and catch block, right? So that we have seen just now. So let us implement that thing. So without try block, in the try block we have to write the code where we are expecting the exceptions, and we have to write the catch block regarding the exceptions to be raised, right? So without try block we should not write the catch block, and without catch block we should not write the try block. Both are interrelated, right? Now let us implement that thing. Class ex, then let us write some exception. So in this we will write a try block because we are expecting some exception here. Try int a is equal to some 5 divided by 0. We know this is an exception, that is divided by 0 exception, right? Right. So if we know the exception names, so as we have discussed just now, there are different exceptions like array index out of bounds exception, number format exception, next arithmetic exception and null pointer exception, and as usual more number of exceptions are there. So if you know the exactly what type of exceptions can be erased, then we can write here directly those exceptions. So here I can expect there might be a chance of getting an arithmetic exception. So here I will give arithmetic exception. So these are the words we need to write as perfectly. So A and E should be capital in arithmetic exception. So what, whenever if there is any arithmetic exception raised in a try block, then that will be assigned to E. That means E will be handling that exception. So if you print this one, system.out.println, if you print E, automatically the exception will be printed. See, class except, let us write the main function, public static void main, write down the command line arguments, create an object for this one, ex, obj is equal to new ex, ex, call that one obj dot display, right? Now let us save this one, execept dot java. Yes, right. Now let us compile this one, java c except dot java. See, here it is compiled successfully. Now we can get the exception, right? See, arithmetic exception divided by zero, it was handled. Now most of you are thinking about this is just to get the error, right? Whenever the exception is erased, then to handle the exception we are using this exception handling. Actually this is used for avoiding the abnormal termination. So I will show you an example. If you are not having this code, try block and a catch block, I have kept in a comments. So the same thing, int a is equal to 5 divided by 0. And next, I am just right system dot out dot println. Here, just I would like to write that exception handled. Right now, actually, here I kept the comments for try and catch block. So only the display method having the two lines of code, that is int a is equal to 5 by 0 and exception handled. Now just we will see executing this one. So we got an error that exception, arithmetic exception divided by 0. See, if the same thing, that means a is equal to 5 divided by 0 is kept in the try block, and after the try and catch, if you write this one more statement like exception handled, see here only the exception will be raised and automatically the rest of the code will be also be executed. So whenever the error occurred in this line, automatically it will be raised to E, and after the catch block, whatever the code you are writing, that code will be executed normally. So it avoids the abnormal termination, right? Hope you understood this thing. So this is the main use of implementing the exception handling concept, right? Now, so this is called the arithmetic exception, and then we will see one more exception, that is arrays index bound, out of bound exception, right? Index out of bound. So let us create a int a is equal to new int some 5. So just I have declared an array with size 5, and I am trying to assign some value to a of 6, that means index 6. So here clearly observe the size of a is declared as 5, but I am accessing the 6th index. So here the size is 5, that means the index values will be from 0 to 4, right? Now I am accessing the 6th index, which is the out of bound. Now it will be raised here. So the exception name is array index out of bounds exception. So we have to write everything perfectly. Here see, A, I, O, B, E, everything will be capital letters. That means every character of the word is capital letter, right? Now the exception, whenever the exception arises, then automatically that exception will be raised and it will be passed out. See, here you can observe array index out of bound exception, that is 6, that is out of bound, right? See, if you write here other than this array out of bound, see, arithmetic exception, right? So here in the code we are getting the array index out of bound exception, but in the catch block we are writing only arithmetic exception. Now what is the result? So the see, right, if you observe here, the next after the catch block, the code is not executed, exception handled is not executed, because here the exception is not handled by any other object, right? So here we are writing arithmetic exception, but here the exception raised is array index out of bound, so catch block will not handle this exception, so automatically the code will be terminated, so this is not executed, this statement, that means after the catch block statement will not be executed. So if you write here arrays index out of bound, array index out of bounds, see, if you write this exception perfectly, then whatever the exception raised in the try block, that will be catch handled by the catch block, and the rest of the code will be executed normally. Here you can observe that the rest of the code is executed. Hope you understood the difference, right? Let us see one more exception, that is number format exception. So string str is equal to some hello, so which is a string, and now I'm just typecasting this one integer dot parseInt of str, right? So here I have to write here int number is equal to something else, right? Now, so here we know that str is of a string type. We kept the string, some assigned some string to str, and in the next line we are trying to convert this string to integer and assign to an integer variable, which is not performed, right? Here we will get the number format exception. See, here also every letter, first letter we must be captured. Number format exception. Now again, if you see that, see number format exception for input string hello, exception handled. Okay, right? Hope you understood this one. And let us see one more exception, that is null pointer exception. So if string is equal to null, and if you are trying to print the length of the string, str.length, we will get the null pointer exception. So here also, the first letter of every word should be capital. Null pointer exception. Here also we can see, sorry. Yes, so small spelling mistake. So null pointer exception. So if you execute this one, so we get a null pointer exception. So here we are assigning some null value to the string, and we are trying to find the print the length of the string. So actually the string doesn't contain any value or some strings. So still we are finding the length of the string, so it will raise an exception called null pointer exception. So these are the few examples for exceptions, runtime exceptions. As I have said just now, these are all called the runtime exceptions, which are handled at the runtime, right? So there are different types of exceptions we have seen, that is checked exceptions, unchecked exceptions. Checked exceptions are compile time exceptions, unchecked exceptions are runtime exceptions. One more thing, if you don't know about, if you are not able to predict what type of exception is available here, I mean, maybe chance of getting, directly you can write here exception E. So automatically, whatever the exception is raised, that exception will be displayed. Null pointer exception, right? See, int A is equal to some 5 by 0. So we know that it is an arithmetic exception, right? But here we are not writing any arithmetic exception here, just we are writing only exception E. So here also we will get arithmetic exception. Arithmetic exception divided by 0. So if you don't know which type of exception may be raised in the code, directly we can give the customized exception, that is a normal exception. Use the keyword exception followed by E and print the E, so that whatever the exception is raised in the try block, that will be handled by the catch block, right? Hope you understood this one. So you can write a more number of catch blocks, right? So a single try block and more number of multiple catch blocks, So multiple exceptions can be handled. So whatever the exception first raised in the try block, the remaining rest of the exceptions will not be raised in the try block. So if you are having both the exceptions, see int b is equal to new int of some 5, b of 6 is equal to some 3. So here two exceptions are there. One is array index out of bounds exception. The another one is arithmetic exception. Now first we have written the arithmetic exception, so only one exception will be raised and it will be displayed on the screen, right? So arithmetic exception. So if one exception is raised, then the rest of the code which is written in the try block will not be executed, right? So if you write this one after the, see, so now what is the first exception to be raised? That is array index out of bound. Next exception is arithmetic exception. So it will not execute the arithmetic exception, that statement. It will just raise the array index out of bound exception. Only one exception will be raised, right? So we have to write this try block carefully, and we have to write the exceptions which we are expecting to be raised in the try block, in the catch block. So whatever the exceptions raised in try block will be handled by the catch block. Right. Once again, I am repeating, the exception handling is used to raise an exception and handle the exception and avoid the abnormal termination of a program. Right. So it will handle the exception and the rest of the code will be executed as usual. Right. So let us stop here. So if you really understood my sessions, like my sessions, share my sessions with your friends, and if you are having any doubts regarding this exception handling, feel free to post your doubts in the comment section so that I will definitely try to clarify all your doubts. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching. Thank you very much.